So a very good morning, students and all the viewers and listeners. Myself, Ankur Kumar, just working as an assistant professor in the Department of Civil Engineering in Buddha Institute of Technology, Gorakhpur, Uttar Pradesh. This college is affiliated to AKTU, that is APJ Abdul Kalam Technical University. First of all, I hope everybody is safe and are doing good in this Corona pandemic. So this pandemic has actually done, it has actually locked everyone in their houses. Even it has barred all the students and the research scholars and the faculty members to not to go in the classroom and to study online. So here I am with a new course that is remote sensing and GIS. And I have designed this course basically for all the students, those who are affiliated to AKTU University and for the Department of Civil Engineering. This will be useful for every student who are willing to, even for research scholar who are willing to study and know about the remote sensing and GIS. I have tried to make the concept very simpler so that it can be understood by a layman person also. So this will be the series of the lecture which will be floated on the YouTube. The link has been provided here and the detail has been also provided in the link. So I welcome you for this online course of remote sensing and GIS. This is actually for the third year students of the Civil Engineering Department affiliated to AKTU. There is a subject named Remote Sensing and GIS. Actually, Remote Sensing and GIS is a course which is useful for all the students, whether they are related to Civil Engineering Department, whether they are related to geography also. Okay, so we'll start this course. And before starting this course, let's have a look towards the content of this. Before starting this course, we'll look the contents of the lecture. So this will be the lecture one, and this will be the part one of the lecture one. Okay, and the contents of this part one will be as follow, and I will be describing each and everything. From today, I will start it from scratch, then we'll tell you about the remote sensing and then about the GIS. So this lecture one is basically about the overview and the introduction of the this remote sensing and GIS. Okay, so before starting this lecture, I will request you all just to have a pen and a notebook so that you can note down some of the bullet points. And I will also provide you the link for the other videos also, so that you can have a detailed knowledge about this remote sensing and GIS. So we'll start with a very scratch part, and we'll start with a very basic question. So before starting, I'm going to just switch off my camera, and will share you the PPT, PowerPoint presentation, and will describe you each and everything in very detail. So once again, welcome to all the students. Let's have start this course with the first lecture and the part one. So here we go. So on a screen, you can see that before we start, let us answer few of the questions. Okay, what is remote sensing? So we'll start with a very basic question, that is, what is remote sensing? What do we measurement, and what kind of output data we get? So what do we measure in this remote sensing or through remote sensing, and what kind of output or data we generate from this remote sensing? So let us start from very basic, like what is an image. So before answering this question, that is, what is remote sensing, what do we measurement, and what kind of output data we get, we have to start with very basic, like what is an image. So you can see this photograph, okay, like this is captured from a normal camera, and normally we call them image. So what is image? Here you can see a photograph, okay, and this photograph is actually has been captured from a normal camera, and we call them image. Okay, you can also see there is another image which is generated from a normal camera or maybe DSLR. Okay, so both these images are actually generated from, it can be generated from a normal camera also, or it can be generated from a DSLR also. Now here you can see there is another image, and here you can see the coverage is more, okay, and generally this kind of photographs are captured using some airborne sensors or maybe satellite sensors. Okay, here you can see there is another image. See, this is also an image, and previously also we have seen two images. Both those images were actually taken from a normal camera or maybe DSLR. But this time, here you can see the coverage is more. Coverage area is more. And this kind of photographs are actually captured using some of the airborne sensors or maybe satellite sensors. Now, here you can see another image. Now, this image is actually produced by a satellite. First image was produced by or generated by a normal camera or DSLR. Other one was created by or generated by some airborne sensors. And now you can see another image which is produced by a satellite. Now, again, here is one more image from satellite. Okay, this image is also being taken from satellite. So what exactly is the difference? You can compare from the beginning like this. So here basically you can understand, like, these images are generated either from a normal camera or from a satellite. So their mode of acquisition is different, right? So their mode of acquisition is different. That is, sometimes we have captured it from airborne sensors. Sometimes we have generated it or captured from a normal camera or DSLR, and sometimes we have generated it from a satellite. Now, here there are two are the different modes through which we capture the images. You can see there are two different modes through which we can capture the images. That is, using the satellite, using the normal camera or DSLR, right? So we can now answer this question, that what is an image. So basically, image is a pictorial representation of an object or a scene. We have two different type of images. First one is analog. Here you can see the first one is analog. Another one is digital. So here you can see the left side house is basically a sketch. Okay, here you can see the left side, this one is a sketch, right? This part is a sketch, okay, and which has been produced using a paper, pencil or pen, right? So this one is basically a sketch. This is a sketch. This is produced by a paper, pencil or a pen, whereas the right hand side image is captured. Here you can see this is a right hand side image which is captured through a sensor or maybe a normal camera or maybe through a mobile phone camera. So the difference between these two is, first one is analog, this one is your analog, right? This one is your analog and this is your digital. Okay, so the difference between these two is, first one is analog and the second one is basically a photograph captured by a sensor. So here there is a definition, or this is how we understand that what do you mean by analog image. So analog images are produced by photographic sensors on paper-based media or transparent media, and variation in scene characteristics are represented as variation in color or grayscale. So it depends on our capability, how well we can depict or how we can represent the variation of an area or an object. Where is camera? It depends on the technical specification of that camera, how well it can acquire or how good images it can produce, right? So this is actually about what is an image. Now moving towards the next slide. The next slide say about the digital image. Basically, the digital images are produced by electro-optical sensor. Okay, you can see one example here, and this is actually you can see through your mobile phone. You might have captured many images or selfie. For example, you have captured images or selfie. If you zoom those images, you will find that there are small rectangular arrays. So those arrays are basically, or those small pixels are basically the numbers which have been captured by your sensors or camera. And if you import them into MATLAB or maybe you see programming, and if you can see those values, you can see they are arranged in a regular manner and where each pixel is having an associated value. And object reflecting more energy, or the object which is appearing very bright in that image, that will be higher number. Whereas the darker portion or the darker areas will have lower values. So here you have a histogram. So from this image, you can easily generate a histogram, and which will look like this. So this is a, here you can see I have generated a histogram, and this actually looks like this. So digital image, you can produce it by your sensor or your camera. So whenever you take some pictures or selfie, and when you import them into the MATLAB or it may be in C, then you can see those values. And if you actually arrange them in a regular manner, where each pixel is having a associated values, and objects reflecting more energy, or the object which is appearing very bright in that image, that will have higher number. Very bright means that will have higher number. Or darker portion, it means the darker area will have the lower value. So this have the significance of the lower value and the higher value. Lower value means darker area, okay? And very high value means very brighter area. So this is about your digital image, right? I think you all are getting me what I am trying to depict through these PPTs, right? Before going to detail in the remote sensing, you have to know about what is an image, what is a digital image, right? Now, as we have now cleared this term, that what is an image, a pictorial representation of an object, and which is also divided as an analog and digital. Now we will move towards another slide. The another slide says remote sensing. Okay. Now, before describing you with the remote sensing, on your screen, I will have X and Y axis. Okay, deco. I have represented you through a X axis and Y axis. In X axis, you will have digital number which has been captured by your satellite or by sensor, and in Y axis, you will have frequency. So for a Gaussian distribution, you will be knowing this, that you will have this kind of distribution. But when you generate a histogram from an image captured in a natural setting, what will happen? This histogram will appear like this, or maybe it appear like this, right? So here we have x-axis and y-axis. X-axis is representing your digital number, which have been captured by your satellite or the sensor. And in y-axis, you will have the frequency. Here you have the frequency. Now, here you can see that in Gaussian distribution, center one, but in the right-hand side, this maximum value is skewed, or maybe it has concentrated in the lower range, whereas here in the left-hand side, it is shifted toward the higher value. Here you can see that in the left-hand side, it is shifted toward the higher values, right? So let us say that this is this particular image, whatever we have considered to generate this histogram, it is having a resolution between 0 to 25. We have a value between 0 to 255. 0 to 255. I'm sorry, it was a slip of tongue. This is also 255, and this is 0 to 255. So by looking at this histogram, which has been generated from this satellite data, or maybe from a normal camera, you can easily find what is the brightness and contrast of this image. If this image is having this Gaussian distribution, so that means it is occupying the full range or available range or this radiometric resolution. But whereas in this image, this has occupied only this particular range. Now, and in this image, it has occupied. So if you see the right-hand side image, this image will look darker, right? This one will look darker, whereas this will appear brighter because it is towards the higher value. See, here you can see the higher value. The higher value will have the brighter image, and the lower value will have the darker image. Okay. So now you have understood what do you mean by image and how it can be generated. So it doesn't matter whether you have used a normal camera or a sensor or a satellite through which you have captured an object or an area and you have generated an image, right? So I guess you all have understood about the Gaussian distribution and what is an image, right? And how we generate the image. And once you generated an image, it actually doesn't matter that you have generated it from the normal camera or a sensor or a satellite. Okay. Now you have also understood that the higher value will be giving you the brighter area, and the lower value will be giving you a darker area, right? So moving towards the next slide, next slide say a definition about the remote sensing. So here we will understand what is actually the remote sensing. So what I can define is, remote sensing is the art and science of making measurements about an object or the environment without being in physical contact with it, right? Remote sensing is the art and science of making measurements about an object or the environment without being in physical contact with it. Remember here, I have written environment also. So what do you mean by environment here? I have also written, see, here I have written the environment. Here you can see I have written environment. So here, what does environment actually mean? I have written environment. So what do you mean by environment? Because normally when we take a photograph through a camera, a regular camera, so we capture the object or we capture ourselves. But how do you capture the environment that you will be understood slowly, right? Remote sensing is the art and science of making measurements about an object or the environment without being in physical contact with it. So the best example of remote sensing is our eyes. So the best example of the remote sensing is our eye, right? How our eye is in best example, I will explain you. We are actually actively engaged in the remote sensing through our eyes, and our eyes' sensitivity is limited to visible range of 400 to 700 nanometers, right? 400 to 700 nanometers. 400 to 500 is our blue color, right? 500 to 600 is our green, and 600 to 700 nanometers is our red wavelength. So whatever we see, that is the combination of this blue, green, and red wavelength. So in general, accepted meaning refers to the instrument-based techniques in remote sensing. So just be clear with some of these terms, right? Remote sensing is actually the measurement of, about an object or the environment without being in physical contact with it. Here I have mentioned you that that best example of remote sensing is our eyes. We are actually actively engaged in the remote sensing through our eyes. How? See, the visible range is starting from 400 to 700 nanometers, right? 400 to 500 is actually blue in color. Blue is your 400 to 500. And 500 to 600 is our green. 500 to 600 is our green. And 600 to 7 nanometer is our red wavelength, right? And whatever we are, we see, that is the combination of this blue, green, and red wavelength, right? Jo bhi hum dekhte hain, these are actually the combination of this blue, green, and red wavelength. So in general accepted meaning, refers to the instrument-based technique in remote sensing. So this is about the remote sensing. And the best example is our eyes. In our day-to-day life, eye is also an example of a remote sensing, right? I think these are clear to you. Now, moving towards the next slide after this remote sensing. The next slide says about the electromagnetic wavelength range, right? This, I hope you all are familiar with this. So here we have radio waves. Here you can see radio waves, microwave, infrared, visible, ultraviolet, X-rays, and gamma rays. So here you can see the information which can be captured using this electromagnetic wavelength length range. Here you can see this. This is the atmospheric window. That is now, see, once again, I will describe you. Here you can see the gamma rays. Right. First of all, this is radio wave. Here is your radio wave. Then is your microwave. Then here is your infrared. Right. Then is your visible. Then is your ultraviolet. After ultraviolet, we have X-rays, and after X-rays, we have gamma rays. Right. After X-rays, we have gamma rays. Okay. Now, here you can see the information which can be captured using this electromagnetic wavelength range. Here you can see this is the atmospheric window. This is your actually the atmospheric window. This atmospheric window, that means these wavelengths are actually allowed to pass through our atmosphere. Atmospheric window ka matlab yehi hota hai ki these wavelengths are actually allowed to pass through our atmosphere. So here you can see the radio wave, this is allowed, and in microwave and infrared, certain portion is not allowed. Okay, so here you can see the radio waves, this is allowed. Radio waves allowed, but in microwave and infrared, certain portion is not allowed. Even in visible, some portion are not allowed. And if you can see the next information, that is electromagnetic wave, the third one is wavelength, you can see. Then size comparison, what kind of information we can get from all these wavelengths. So starting from a nuclei, starting from a nuclei to starting from a nuclei to a building, starting from a nuclei to a building, you can always use this technology. Then frequency is also related to this, and then temperature, energy for the emission. So this is your electromagnetic wavelength range, right? Starting from the radio waves, microwave, infrared, visible, ultraviolet, X-rays, and gamma rays, right? And we can see some of the wavelengths, okay? That means you can see the atmospheric window. That means these wavelengths are actually allowed to pass through our atmosphere. ठीक है, यहाँ पे atmospheric window का मतलब यही है कि ये wavelengths जो है हमारे atmosphere से पास करने को allowed है, right? So this is actually about the electromagnetic wavelength range. In next slide, I will also describe you something more about this electromagnetic wavelength range. Just wait a second. See, in this case, sun is our source of the light, right? You can see here sun. Everybody can see here sun. Sun, here sun is our source of light. So when sun is illuminating our surface, right, then what will happen? Just suppose when sun is illuminating our surface, then what will happen? Either it will reflect it back. Okay, either it will get reflected from our surface, you can see very clearly from our surface, or it will get transmitted. Ya to uska reflection hoga, ya to uska transmission hoga, or it will get absorbed. Or if it is absorbing some amount of energy, then later on it will be emitted. Okay? See, whenever sun is illuminating your surface, either some amount of energy is reflected back, some amount of energy is actually transmitted, and some amount of energy is actually absorbed. And just suppose if the some amount of energy is getting absorbed, then later on it will be emitted. So in visible, it is 0.4. Visible range is 0.4 to 0.7 micrometer, 0.4 to 0.7 micrometer. And in VNIR and SWIR wavelength range, it is actually start from 0.7 micrometer to 2.5 micrometer. And this comes under reflective domain, right? In the next one, when there is absorption of this incident energy, an object has to maintain that equilibrium with the surrounding. So what will happen? There will be some emission. So those emitted energy will be captured through our sensor. ठीक है, जब emission होगा तो ये emission जो emitted energy है ये हमारे sensor के द्वारा क्या किया जाएगा, ये हमारे sensors के द्वारा record किया जाएगा, right? उसे कैप्चर कौन करेगा, हमारा सेंसर. सो दिस इज थर्मल इंफ्रारेड वेवलेंथ विच स्टार्ट फ्रॉम 3 माइक्रोमीटर टू 16 माइक्रोमीटर, राइट? सो द नेक्स्ट वन इज योर माइक्रोवेव एंड इट रेंज इज फ्रॉम 0.1 सेंटीमीटर टू 1 मीटर. देखो बहुत आराम से इसको समझने की कोशिश करें आप लोग, ठीक है? अगर हमारा सन सरफेस को एल्यूमिनेट कर रहा है, तो जब हमारा सन सरफेस को एल्यूमिनेट करेगा तो अनडाउटेबली देयर विल बी द रिफ्लेक्शन, ट्रांसमिशन और एमिशन, सॉरी, और एब्जॉर्प्शन. एंड इफ सम अमाउंट इज गेटिंग एब्जॉर्ब, इट विल लेटर इट विल बी एमिटेड. एंड दैट रेंज इज थर्मल इंफ्रारेड विच इज रेंजिंग बिटवीन 3 माइक्रोमीटर टू 16 माइक्रोमीटर. एंड वॉट इज द रेंज ऑफ माइक्रोवेव? इट इज 0.1 सेंटीमीटर टू 1 meter. So other one is microwave. And what happens here, the sensors or the satellite, it has its own source of light, right? So it will eliminate the surface and the back scattering energy will be captured here, right? Yahan pe kya ho raha hai ki jo aapka sensors hai, it is illuminating through its own source of energy. And and whatever there is scattered part, and that back scattering energy will be captured here. So this is about the electromagnetic wavelength range. Visible is 0.4 micrometer to 0.7 micrometer, and thermal infrared is VNIR and SWIR is 0.7 micrometer to 2.5 micrometer. Thermal infrared is 3 micrometer to 16 micrometer, and microwave is 0.1 centimeter to 1 meter. Right. Now, after this electromagnetic wavelength range, we'll have one question. That have you ever thought that what happens when light hits an object? Have you actually think about it? So what happens when light hits an object? So this is actually very basic information which I am giving you all, but this is very important in order to understand this remote sensing technology. So here you can see there is an object. Here is one object. I will show you the object. This is your object. Okay. Now, and there is a source of light, and light is coming from the source. Okay. And this source is from the source, and this hits the target, and the light has interacted. Then what will happen? Some amount of energy will get reflected. Here, the some amount of energy is getting reflected back. Some of are getting scattered, right? Scattered in different directions. So some amount of energy is reflected and some amount of energy is scattered, right? We can see here is the incident light from the source. Then some amount of energy is reflected and some amount of energy is scattered. After scattering, some will be absorbed and some will be emitted by this object. Okay, and some will be emitted by this object, and so finally get transmitted. Kya ho raha hai? Jab ek source se ek object pe target pe incident light hit kar rahi hai, so some amount of energy is reflected back, some is getting scattered, and object is emitting some amount of energy, and finally some amount of energy is transmitted, right? Yahan tak clear hai na? I guess this is clear. Okay. So here you can see some amount of energy is actually transmitted. So some will be scattered, some will be absorbed, and some will be emitted by this object. So, and finally transmitted. Okay. So if you add all these energy like absorbed, transmitted, scattered, emitted, and reflected, what will happen? It will be equal to your incident light, internal atomic structure, and composition are the reason of absorption feature. So kya karenge hum? Hum reflected light ko, right, transmitted, absorbed or scattered, in sabhi ko kya karenge? Isko add kar denge. So if you add all these energies like absorbed, transmitted, scattered, emitted, and reflected, what will happen? It will be equal to your incident light. Okay, that will be equal to this incident light, right? And internal atomic structure and composition are the reason of absorption features, because these energies are coming from a source to a target. Then what will happen? There will be some characteristic of this particular object which is causing this particular energy to get changed in different forms. So if you understand the reflected, emitted, scattered, absorbed, or transmitted energy, you can understand the target. So you, if you have the sensor and you, if you can measure the reflected or emitted energy, then in your information which has been captured, this will look like this, right? This will be look like this. Okay. This will look like this. Okay. So here in this case, the measurement is basically values, right? We are not generating any image. So there is an instrument which can measure the emitted energy at a regular interval for a given target. So here using that you will have, may have 100 second, 1000 second, or maybe 10,000 seconds data point captured by the sensors, and then easily you can draw them wavelength versus that value. Here these are the areas where you can see there is some change, right? There you can see the some of the changes, right? I have also represented those changes, right? Here you can see some of the changes. And remember, because this is the material characteristic, why we are getting all these troughs. We are getting this trough. Here you can see one trough, right? Here you can see the second trough, right? So here it is important that these troughs need to be studied thoroughly, because if you don't study, you will lose the information. And that is why I have mentioned troughs are the places where things are happening and distribution of electromagnetic radiation emitted or absorbed by the particular object. It is a function of the wavelength. Okay. So, jahan jahan trough hai, right, are the areas where the things are happening and there is the distribution of the electromagnetic radiation emitted or absorbed by that particular object. So, always remember, a material can be categorized using this information, provide their absorption feature is actually identified at a particular wavelength range. And how do you plot such spectrum that we have already discussed? You have a sensor which can capture these energies, emitted or reflected energy at regular intervals, and that will be stored in some digital number, and that we are displaying here, right? So I guess this is very clear to you now that what is an image, how we record that digital image, and what happens when light hits an object, and how that number is actually plotted, okay, that distribution of electromagnetic radiation emitted or absorbed by that particular object, it is actually a function of the wavelength. Okay, I guess these all are clear to you in a very, easy manner. Now, if these things are clear, now we will moving towards the next slide. And what does next slide say? This describes the different. Now, if you have understood these all things, now we have to study about the stages in the remote sensing from the space. Right. So if the things are clear till the previous slide, now we're moving towards this slide. And this slide says about the stages in remote sensing from space. So there are various stages in remote sensing, and especially when we are talking about the space-borne satellites. So here you can see there are stages listed over here. Electromagnetic energy reflected or emitted by the object. Electromagnetic energy reflected or emitted by the object, right? Now, first of all, the electromagnetic energy is reflected or emitted by the object, right? After this, so first of all, some sun is our source, and then it is getting reflected or emitted from the surface, right? सबसे पहला चीज हमें जानना है कि जो सन है वो हमारा सोर्स है, राइट? सन इज अवर सोर्स, एंड देन इट इज गेटिंग, आइदर इट इज गेटिंग रिफ्लेक्टेड और इट इज एमिटेड फ्रॉम द सरफेस, एंड देन इट इज रीचिंग टू अवर सैटेलाइट, एंड देन सैटेलाइट विल रिकॉर्ड दिस एनर्जी, ठीक है? देन वेयर इट इज रीचिंग, देन इट इज, सी हियर इट इज योर सन, ओके? द फर्स्ट स्टेज इज योर सन. आफ्टर दिस सन इज इल्यूमिनेटिंग द एनर्जी, either it is reflected or emitted by the object, and then it is reaching to our satellite, and then satellite will record the energy, okay? And this satellite will record this energy, and then there is a ADC analog to digital converter which converts this incident energy into some value, right? अभी मैंने आपको बताया ना कि डिजिटल इमेज क्या होता है, 0-1 कैसे उसको रिकॉर्ड करते हैं और क्या शो करता है, एक्चुअली उसका एप्लीकेशन अब यहीं पर होगा, ठीक है। अब क्या करेगा, जो एडीसी एनालॉग है वो डिजिटल कन्वर्टर में उसको इस इंसिडेंट एनर्जी को कुछ वैल्यूज में कन्वर्ट करेगा, ठीक है। जितनी भी एनर्जी है उसकी कुछ वैल्यू होती है डिजिटल नंबर में, और ये एडीसी एनालॉग उसको कन्वर्ट करेगा, एंड दोज वैल्यूज विल बी रिकॉर्डेड एंड इमेज विल बी जनरेटेड। ओके, वेरी क्लियर। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, सन, सन इज एक्चुअली इल्यूमिनेटिंग द सर्फेस, आइदर इट इज रिफ्लेक्टेड, आइदर इट इज स्कैटर्ड, आइदर इट इज एमिटेड or absorbed and finally transmitted. Now the reflected energy is recorded by the sensor, satellite, right? And this ADC analog is what it is doing. It is converting this energy into some of the digital number. And this is finally generating an image. So these values are stored and captured, and then you are getting an image. Okay? So, This is actually the different stages for the remote sensing from space, right? And these values will be recorded and image will be generated, and then finally those stored values and the captured image that will be transmitted to our ground station, and then from the ground station it will be distributed to users through different media. Okay, देखो, इफ आई हैव टू डिस्क्राइब यू दिस होल फिनोमिना, आई विल हैव टू मूव टूवर्ड्स द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड। सी, दिस इज टू मेक यू क्लियर, दिस स्लाइड इज एक्चुअली टू मेक यू मोर क्लियर दैट सन इज आवर सोर्स ऑफ एनर्जी, समझ आ गया, विच इज इरेडिएटिंग आवर सर्फेस। हियर यू कैन सी सन विच इज इरेडिएटिंग आवर सर्फेस and which actually interact with atmosphere. Here it is actually interacting with the atmosphere, and in atmosphere we have different gases, we have aerosols, and those will play a role to stop this energy in a particular wavelength range. Itna clear hai ki we have a source of energy that is sun, which is irradiating our surface and which actually interact with our atmosphere, and in atmosphere we have different gases, aerosols, and those aerosols, those gases will play a role to stop this energy in a particular wavelength range. So here what is happening, the energy which is coming from the sun to the surface, that is getting changed or modified because of our atmosphere. See, sun se jo energy aayi, wo atmosphere pe aerosols aur gases se kahin na kahin interact karegi, और जब हमारे सरफेस पे जो एनर्जी पहुंच रही है वो मॉडिफाइड फॉर्म में है, क्यों, क्योंकि वो एटमॉस्फेयर से होते हुए आ रही है, तो जो एरोसॉल्स है, जो मॉलिक्यूल्स हैं गैसेस के, वो उसको इंटरैक्ट करके उसको मॉडिफाई कर रहे हैं, ठीक है। एंड सम ऑफ द एनर्जी विच विल कम डायरेक्टली टू अवर सर्फेस, एंड वंस इट गेट रिफ्लेक्टेड फ्रॉम द सर्फेस अगेन, इट विल इंटरैक्ट, इट हैज टू पास थ्रू अवर एटमॉस्फेयर एंड देन विल रीच टू अवर सैटेलाइट। ओके, मान लो कुछ एनर्जी डायरेक्टली आ भी गई, तो फिर से इसको क्या करना है, फिर से इसको एटमॉस्फेयर के थ्रू पास करना है, जब वो रिफ्लेक्ट होगा बैक, और जब ये एटमॉस्फेयर के थ्रू पास होगा उसके बाद ही ये हमारे सैटेलाइट तक रीच करेगा, राइट। सो एंड देयर कुड बी दिस प्रोसेस ऑल्सो वेयर लाइट इज कमिंग डायरेक्टली एंड इट इज गेटिंग मॉडिफाइड इन दिस पर्टिकुलर एटमॉस्फेयरिक विंडो, ठीक है। एटमॉस्फेरिक विंडो का मतलब उस पर्टिकुलर वेवलेंथ पे, ठीक है, एंड मे बी सम ऑफ द एनर्जी विल गेट रिफ्लेक्टेड डायरेक्टली फ्रॉम द एटमॉस्फेयर एंड विच विल बी एडेड टू आवर दिस रिफ्लेक्टेड एनर्जी। सो दिस इज वन ऑफ द प्रोसेस। और दूसरे प्रोसेस में क्या होता है, वेयर एमिटेड एनर्जी इज इन्वॉल्व, सो सम ऑफ द एनर्जी विच इज गॉट एब्जॉर्ब हियर एंड इट विल गेट रिफ्लेक्टेड आफ्टर सम टाइम, सो those energy will be emitted and this will reach to our sensor. Here it is our sensor, okay, it will reach to our sensor, and there will be some atmospheric emission also, and then finally you have a field data collection. Here you can see have a field data collection, here you can see the field data collection, right? Then you have this field data collection, okay? So then you will have this field data collection. So here it is important to understand that what are the different types of remote sensing we do, as well as how we do this, right? So here it is, this slide actually clears the stages in the remote sensing from the space. क्या होता है कि जो सूरज से जो भी एनर्जी आपकी सरफेस को रेडिएट कर रही है, एक्चुअली वो एटमोस्फियर से इंटरेक्ट करती है, ठीक है, डिफरेंट वेवलेंथ पे, डिफरेंट गैसेस, डिफरेंट एरोसॉल्स हमको मिलते हैं, और जो भी एनर्जी आपकी डायरेक्टली आ रही है वो भी एक बार जो रिफ्लेक्ट होगी तो फिर से इंटरेक्ट होगी एटमोस्फियर से, तभी आपको सैटेलाइट के पास वो पहुंचेगी और वहां प्रोसेसिंग होगी, राइट? So it will be passing through and modifying in particular atmospheric window, and maybe some of the energy will be get reflected directly from the atmosphere, and which will be added to our this reflected energy. And so this is one of the process, right? So this is how we actually record the energy in the case of remote sensing. Pehle aapko ek source chahiye. सोर्स से आपका वो सरफेस को इरेडिएट करती है, इरेडिएट करने के बाद वो कुछ अमाउंट रिफ्लेक्ट होता है, रिफ्लेक्ट होने के बाद वो सेंसर्स जो सैटेलाइट इमेजेस हैं उससे वो रिकॉर्ड होता है, रिकॉर्ड क्योंकि वो इंट्रैक्ट होकर एटमॉस्फेयर से पहुंचता है, उसके बाद वो एक एटमॉस्फेरिक विंडो में उस वेवलेंथ रेंज पे उसको हम इमेज में कन्वर्ट करते हैं जो कि फील्ड डेटा कलेक्शन में रिकॉर्ड किया जाता है, राइट? सो दिस इज दिस स्लाइड इज ऑल अबाउट द स्टेजेस इन द रिमोट सेंसिंग फ्रॉम द स्पेस. नाउ दिस स्लाइड विल डिस्क्राइब यू अबाउट द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ रिमोट सेंसिंग एंड विच वन इज बेटर एक्चुअली. सो देर आर बेसिकली टू टाइप्स, एक्टिव एंड पैसिव रिमोट सेंसिंग. हियर इज एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ पैसिव रिमोट सेंसिंग. Deco, first we'll have an example of passive remote sensing. See, we can see the left side of the our slide has this passive remote sensing. So where sun is our source, right? In the passive remote sensing, sun is our source and which is illuminating our target. Sun kya kar raha hai? It is illuminating our target. Our target is their tree, okay, and which get reflected from the surface. And then it is captured by our sensor. यही है रिमोट सेंसिंग का पूरा प्रिंसिपल. ये सोर्स है, यहाँ पे सन हमारा सोर्स है, ये टारगेट को हिट किया, जो रिफ्लेक्टेड एनर्जी है वो सेंसर यानी कि रिसीवर्स के द्वारा रिकॉर्ड किया जा रहा है. सो हियर इन दिस केस द सेंसर यूजेस द सन्स एनर्जी एज अ सोर्स ऑफ रेडिएशन, एज अ सोर्स ऑफ रेडिएशन. एंड इन नेक्स्ट केस, जो नेक्स्ट केस है, अदर केस वेयर सोर्स इज एक्चुअली source is actually carried by the sensor, ठीक है? तो sensor है हमारा, वही source को carry कर रहा है, ठीक है? पहले case में क्या हो रहा है कि हमारा जो source है वो क्या है, वो sun है, वहां से हमारा वो target को hit कर रहा है. So sensor uses the sun's energy as a source of radiation and it is actually recorded by the sensor. Now in the case of active remote sensing, we have the sensors which is actually carrying this source, right? So here we can see the source also coming from this particular sensor, and then once it get in reflected, it will be received by the same sensor. Source jo hai wo sensor source ko carry karta hai, wahan se energy reflect hoti hai, theek hai, aur fir wo sensor usko record karta hai same sensor se. So here this is the this is the description. I hope this is clear, active versus passive remote sensing, because this is very important that we'll understand in the later age, right? So this is actually the basic difference between the active remote sensing versus passive remote sensing. In active remote sensing, sense energy is actually used for the radiation, and the sensors, in the case of active remote sensing, the sensors uses its own source of radiation. So this is this slide actually describes you about active versus passive remote sensing. Now moving towards the next slide. The next slide is about the orbit. So till now we have cleared the basic concepts about image, then digital image, and then about the some of the basic principles of the remote sensing, and then we have also seen the concepts about active versus passive remote sensing. Now we have to also look towards the different types of the orbit. Now why we need to understand the orbit? Because satellites are fixed in these orbits. Okay, now there are different types of orbit, and how these satellites are fixed and how these satellites are monitoring our surface. So this is one of the orbit, polar orbiting satellite, where orbit altitude is approximately 850 kilometers, okay, and which is actually more or less 14 orbits per day. So satellites जो है वो ऑर्बिट में फिक्स किए जाते हैं, तो इसलिए हमको ऑर्बिट के बारे में एक ब्रीफ डिस्क्रिप्शन और उसका एक ब्रीफ आइडिया होना बहुत ही जरूरी है. राइट, यू कैन सी एंड इट इज यूज फॉर अर्थ सो दिस इज वन ऑफ द ऑर्बिट पोलर ऑर्बिटिंग सैटेलाइट वेयर ऑर्बिट एल्टीट्यूड इज अप्रोक्सीमेटली 850 किलोमीटर एंड विच इज एक्चुअली मोर और लेस 14 ऑर्बिट पर डे. You can see and it is used for earth exploration as well as earth observation. So iska kaam kya hai, ye earth exploration aur earth observation mein kaam aata hai, theek hai. So this is your polar orbiting satellite. Right, now and the next one which is very commonly used geostationary satellite, theek hai. Pehle to ho gaya polar orbiting ke baad jo hum पोलर ऑर्बिटिंग का एल्टीट्यूड 850 किलोमीटर है और 14 ऑर्बिट्स पर डे और यूज फॉर अर्थ ऑब्जर्वेशन एंड अर्थ एक्सप्लोरेशन. नाउ वी हैव अदर ऑर्बिट. नाउ द अदर ऑर्बिट इज एक्चुअली सॉरी आई थिंक आई हैव नॉट मेंशन द दिस जियो स्टेशनरी और जियो साइनाकोरस सैटेलाइट. नो डाउट, नो प्रॉब्लम. वी will describe you about the geostationary satellite also. So this altitude of this orbit is 35,786 kilometer, which is approximately 36,000 kilometer and one orbit in 24 hours. The satellite actually appear to be fixed on the sky and look at this same location on the earth, which is very clear from this image. So here you can see this particular satellite is always looking at a one particular position. So this is a very good to monitor some kind of changes or regular monitoring of an area. But due to high altitude, the spatial resolution is very less. The spatial resolution, I know it is again it will be a new term for you all guys, but just you have to wait from some of the slide also, then I will tell you about the resolution. This is actually in the lecture one only. In the part two, I will be telling you about the resolution. That is, and then you will understand about the spatial resolution and how it is used for the earth exploration, and then about the weather monitoring and then the communication. Okay. Now, other orbit is low inclination orbit. So next one is your low inclination orbit. So orbit altitude is approximately 160 kilometers and orbital period is about 88 minutes, provide the high receptivity of tropics. Object below 160 kilometer experience the rapid orbital decay and altitude loss. So you can see this one. Here is the example of low orbiting satellite. So orbit altitude is 160 kilometers and orbital period is about 88 minutes. And it provides the high receptivity of tropics, and object below 160 kilometer experience rapid orbital decay and altitude loss. Right. So after this orbit, that is three types of orbit, that is low inclination orbit and geostationary orbit and polar satellite orbit now sorry polar orbit polar orbiting satellite. Now we will describe you about the platform, right? अगर आपको यहाँ तक चीजें समझ में आ गई हैं, तो नेक्स्ट जो टर्म है जो आपको समझना है वो क्या है कि प्लेटफॉर्म. और ये टर्म बहुत ही इम्पोर्टेंट है बिकॉज वी हैव टू एक्चुअली नो अबाउट दिस टर्म बिकॉज रिमोट सेंसिंग में इस टर्म का काफी क्रूशियल पार्ट है, राइट? सो देर आर डिफरेंट प्लेटफॉर्म from where we capture these remote sensing data, right? So let us start with satellite. So here you can see there is a fixed in on the orbit is fixed in space. ठीक है, अगर हमारे पास सैटेलाइट है तो वो एक ऑर्बिट में जा करके फिक्स हो जा रहा है. Here you can see there is satellite, there it is fixed in an orbit, right? So fixed in a space or in orbit. So this is called space borne satellite. इसको हम क्या कहते हैं, इसको हम कहते हैं space borne satellite. This is known as your space borne satellite. And there are some space shuttles. They are also carrying some cameras and they are capturing the images. in the airborne, basically we use aerial photography or airborne SAR, that is above the ground of 10 to 12 kilometers of range, right? So if we use the satellite, we can see that there is a fixed that this is fixed in the orbit in space. So this is called a space borne satellite. And there are some space shuttles. They are also carrying some cameras and they are capturing the images. In the airborne, basically we use the aerial photography or airborne SAR. Okay, we use different camera which are operating in different wavelengths and which we attach to our for example, I will take an example ki aisa kya hota hai ki camera ka different wavelength hota hai. Agar us camera ko hum ek helicopter se attach kar de, we attach to our helicopter or flight or maybe drones, you can see here. So here you can see there are different types of or different modes of acquisition, and depending upon their altitude their nomenclature will be different. Here you can see this is example of airborne survey. Isko hum kehte hain airborne survey, right? So this is how it is done. So you can see this particular area where we have captured already, and this particular craft is moving forward, right? So yahan pe kuch ek particular area main aapko dikha raha hu jo ki already captured hai. और ये आपका जो एरिया है, सॉरी ये जो हेलीकॉप्टर है वो आगे की तरफ मूव करके और एरिया को कवर कर रहा है. सो दिस इज द एक्टिव एरिया वेयर दिस फ्लाइट इज बेसिकली, और दिस इज एयरबोर्न सेंसर इज कैप्चरिंग दिस इमेज. तो प्लेटफॉर्म का मतलब ये हुआ कि जो हमारे सेंसर्स है वो डिफरेंट लोकेशन पे जाकर के जाकर के वहां पे फिक्स किए जाते हैं. फिर वहां से हम क्या करते हैं, वहां से हम डेटा को एक्विजिशन उसका एक्वायर करते हैं, राइट? सो दिस इज अबाउट योर प्लेटफॉर्म, राइट? दिस इज एक्चुअली अबाउट योर प्लेटफॉर्म, राइट? सो टिल नाउ वी हैव कवर्ड दीज पार्ट्स. आई गेस दीज आर क्लियर टू यू. दीज आर द बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ द रिमोट सेंसिंग. सो टिल नाउ वी हैव कवर्ड टिल प्लेटफॉर्म. Now the next one is about the application of remotely sensed images. Okay, so I guess this part is clear to you, right? After this, this is actually the part one, right? So this lecture one is about your overview and introduction of this remote sensing and GIS. And till now we have covered so many parts. Okay, till now we have covered this image. What is an image? Digital image, remote sensing, electromagnetic wavelength range, stages in remote sensing from space, active versus passive remote sensing, orbits, and then platform. Now we have to cover about the application of the remote sensing, right? What are the application of the remote remotely sensed images? Okay, and then we have to cover about the other things also, that is types of resolution. So I guess all the students, you all listening to me very carefully, and these all things are clear to you till now. So what I am doing, I am just wrapping this, winding up this lecture one, part one, till platform, because it will be a very, then will be a very lengthy video, and then will be very tedious for you all guys. So I am wrapping it here. I am winding up this part one. Now what I will do, I will create another video, that is part two of the lecture one, and then we'll cover the different parts, that is including the application of remotely sensing, remotely sensed images, and then the types of resolution, right? So we'll covering this lecture one in different parts, so that the video is not lengthy and it is very easy for you all guys to understand it. Okay, so I guess this is clear to you all, and if you have any doubt, you can write to me on my mail ID, that is ankur495@bit.ac.in, and I hope everybody is safe around you also, including you in your family member in this corona pandemic. So thank you for listening to me. I will be back to you tomorrow with the lecture second part of this lecture one. So till now, thank you so much. Thank you for your patience. Thank you.